It's one of the world's busiest megacities. But 5 centuries ago, when Mexico City was called Mexico Tenochtitlan, it was perhaps the most advanced metropolis on Earth. Archaeologist Raúl Barreras says that when the Spanish arrived, they found a thriving society with a level of sophistication none of them could have imagined.
What does Hernán Cortés find? A very well-planned city with an entire government structure. A city we know in its time was one of the largest in the world, bigger than Paris.
This year marks the 500th anniversary of the fall of Tenochtitlan. The famous capital of the Aztec Empire featured inventive engineering practices, farming techniques, and waterways that made it a marvel of human ingenuity.
Mexico Tenochtitlan was a small island that grew over time with the continuous process of building over chinampas, which we can still see to this day in the southern part of the city.
In the summer of 1521, months after the arrival of Cortes and the capture of Mexica leader Moctezuma, tensions between the Spanish and the native population reached a boiling point. War broke out over control of the city, but it was the Spaniards who were forced to flee. The Tenochtitlan victory, however, was short-lived. Cortes and his men would soon return with some 20,000 indigenous allies, sworn enemies of Aztec rule, and conquered the city.
Cortes makes the decision to build a new city, and to do so destroys Tenochtitlan. With those same materials, he builds the new city, new palaces, the homes of Hernán Cortes and his captains. Lands were divided, and with the same stones and the same hands of the native people, they built a new city.
Despite the destruction of Mexico Tenochtitlan, vestiges like this aqueduct that once channeled water across the ancient city still exist side by side with the towering metropolis that is the modern Mexican capital. As Mexican political leaders seek to commemorate the Spanish conquest with a series of special events throughout 2021, the anniversary appears to have also sparked a renewed enthusiasm for pre-Columbian heritage.
What I feel remains today is a sense of grandeur. There's a pride among the people of the city to be the descendants of that ancient Tenochtitlan.
A recent poll found that more than half of residents in the Mexican capital would be in favor of changing the city's name back to Mexico Tenochtitlan. Manuel Rapallo, Al Jazeera, Mexico City.